Good morning, Colonel Bai.
Today is Wednesday, January 12th.
I'm Josh.
And I'm Dylan.
And here are your morning announcements. First, I want to say a very happy International Kiss a Ginger Day.
Anyways, attention grade 12 students pursuing a university program in science, technology, engineering, or mathematics. The Schulett Leader Scholarships are the largest undergraduate STEM scholarships in Canada, with a value of up to $100,000, each to be used at one of the 20 partner universities.
Criteria includes academic excellence, which is a 90-plus average of grade 11 and 12 URM marks, leadership and or financial need. See more information on the website below. And email Ms. Badry and guidance for an application form. Applications are due to guidance by midnight tonight. Oh, Dilly Dog, have you bought yourself a yearbook yet?
I can't say I have.
Why ever not?
Well, I haven't seen enough convincing advertisements to buy one yet.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I have just the thing for you. If I convinced you a few months ago, but how are you feeling about it now?
Believe me, my friend, my orders are so in.
Excellent.
Yeah. Photo day is scheduled for January 21st. Stay tuned to CV to hear if that date changes.
And please remember to follow OPH guidelines to help keep everybody safe and get us back to CB as soon as possible.
Yeah, you know, I really do want to go back to CB. I mean, there's nothing fun to do around here. Like,
Dylan, don't you remember? We just made a list of things for the lovely students of Colonel Bai to do in lockdown.
Oh yeah! Those dumplings were so good.
What's up, Cougars? It's Josh and Dylan, and we're here to cure your boredom. What have we done?
We have made a top 5 list of things you guys can do to stay not bored in lockdown.
Let's get straight into it.
You're welcome. Number 5 is to make yourself a nice meal. Cooking some pork and shrimp dumplings, my favorite. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is boil some water like so. We've already taken the liberty of boiling some water, so you don't have to sit and wait. The next thing you're gonna wanna do is pour the dumplings very carefully into the water and avoid getting the packaging in the water as well. And put the lid on, don't forget. It's called steaming.
So good.
I've never had an unsatisfied customer.
Number 4, get your creative juices flowing. You know, make some art, take some pictures, or even make a song.
Coming in at number 3, we have building a pillow fort. Hey guys, we just built this nice little fort. It also doubles as an online classroom. Come on in, let me show you. Now that we've made this beautiful fort and the dumplings have been digested, it's time for some studying. This beautiful fort also happens to double as an online classroom. So when they ask me to turn on my camera, I'll be the most fashionable kid in the class.
Number 2. Practice those pickup lines to impress that special somebody for CB's Lova Day. It's coming up quick.
You know what they say about a virus? Can't spell it without you and I.
If I had to make a Patronus, I'd just think of you.
Is your name Quarantine? Because you can't spell it without URQT. So you want to be my Valentine?
Sorry, Josh. I'm just in love with Dylan.
No! Coming in at number 1, hit a sick trick shot. Man, I am exhausted.
Me too. We got through the entire list.
Yeah, but you know what?
My boredom is cured!
Mine as well, so it's gotta be scientifically proven.
It's gotta work!
So come on, Cougars, try it yourself.
Try it yourself, and take care.
Peace.
You know, I gotta say, Big J, your artistic abilities are quite something.
What can I say? I'm blessed. It's a gift.
Winterlude's Lost Children's Services is looking for volunteers during Winterlude on Saturday, February 12th and Sunday, February 13th. To register, go to the link on screen.
Indeed. You know, Dylan, we've been in this pandemic for so long now, I'm beginning to feel a little isolated from the rest of the world.
You know, I agree, but we can always check in to see how the pandemic is affecting the lives of international students.
Hey, CB. We're all experiencing firsthand the impacts of the recent surge in COVID cases across Canada. But what's happening in the rest of the world? Well, the US and most of Europe are experiencing the same thing we are. Cases are skyrocketing everywhere, with the US announcing a record 1.5 million new cases on Monday alone. These countries have taken a more relaxed approach as a result of the new wave, accepting the record high case counts as inevitable. Some are hopeful that these could lead to herd immunity and an end to the pandemic. Elsewhere, Asian countries are also experiencing case surges due to Omicron, but to a much lesser extent due to their tighter lockdown and testing measures. One notable exception is China, which has managed to mostly contain Omicron due to their zero COVID lockdown policy. Under this policy, cities that experience outbreaks are almost completely shut down, with residents confined to their houses and government deliveries of essential items. Many have complained about the draconian nature of these policies, though official case counts have remained in the hundreds, while most other countries see cases in the tens and hundreds of thousands. Finally, it is important to note that much of the world continues to lack access to vaccines. Only 50% of the world is fully vaccinated, in part due to vaccine hesitancy, but also because many countries simply cannot afford to purchase enough vaccines for their citizens. But progress is being made. Improvements are being made to vaccines, and antiviral pills that minimize symptoms in those already infected have recently been developed. While the world continues to wait on a solution to this crisis, remember, CB, it's important to continue to follow guidelines and regulations to keep us all safe and get us through this as quickly as possible.
We're in this together, Cougars.
Now, it's time for your favorite segment of the week. Wait in Wednesday! We asked you guys what you miss most about having in-person learning, and there's a tie between having classes in person and seeing your friends in person.
Honestly, I miss that too.
Same here, brother.
We asked you guys if you turn on your cameras for remote learning, and 52.2% of you guys said no!
How are you doing? You seem like the type to have your camera on.
Actually, I do not.
Why? What are you doing when it's off?
That's classified.
And finally, we asked you guys what your favorite pandemic takeout was, and 43.5% of you said pizza.
Unpopular opinion here. I believe pineapple has a home on pizza.
Unpopular opinion here. I don't believe that sauce does.
Tell them.
Tell them.
That's all from us today, CB. Have a Walla Walla Washington Wednesday.